Now, as you may know, I do these videos so I can talk about what I'm gonna talk about, you know, I'm gonna express my opinions towards you, the viewers, before you buy some of this stuff if you are interested in actually knowing about it, if you just don't really care and you just want to spend whatever. Alright, so today we are going to be looking at Little Big Planet 1, or just in general, Little Big Planet. Playing it myself, it was really, really fun. I'm not going to go into detail about how I feel about it. It's just a really good game. You know, you're going to put in some hours into the campaign or the story, and the story is honestly really good. I mean, it doesn't have special Michael Bay effects, you know, like Little Big Planet 3, where like, it's the first Little Big Planet. Back then, they didn't have any emotions, any acting, or, you know, any special effects like we get right now on Little Big Planet 3, but we just get a simple, nice, working game. And the community, well, the community is kind of trash, but at the same time, it, you know, you can find yourself some really good levels. But yeah, overall, it's a simple game. If you're in for the trophies, it's a really easy platinum. If you want to play online, there's a few people here and there playing. I mean, the online community is a little big. It's not that big. If you're hoping to find people to play with, I would suggest going in the weekends. You can probably find some people to play with on the weekends. It just depending what day it is, you know. And being the first out of all the other sequels, or whatever you want to call it, you know, Little Big Planet 2, Little Big Planet 3, Little Big Planet Karting, Little Big Planet PS Vita, Little Big Planet PSP, you know, being the first of the first makes it valuable. You know, you got to play the first one to go to the second one, and then the third one. It's just like Fast and Furious, you know, you got to watch the first Fast and Furious, and then you got to watch the second one, and then the third one. And, you know, it's a situation where, like, karting is Tokyo Drift, you know, it's just like, how does that fit? It's basically Tokyo Drift. If it fits after, you know, I believe number 6 or number 7, I'm not sure, one of those. But let's get into conclusion, because you guys have been hearing me talk this whole video, and I'm gonna cut to the chase. Should you buy it? Yes, you should buy it. And I don't make these videos just to say yeah you should buy it. This specific game actually changed a lot of lives, and it changed my life. I think this game is worth it, and I think if you actually play the whole campaign, you play as much as you can on the game, you will actually love it. You will love it. You'll love it to death. And I think it will motivate you to get Little Big Planet 2, probably. I'm not sure. That's a little too crazy. You know, you don't want to get out of hand. I believe right now you can actually get it GameStop for like $10, I believe. I don't know. Depending on where you live. Last time I checked was like a month ago. I bought Little Big Planet, another copy of Little Big Planet, for $8. $7.99, I believe. But you can actually get it digital for $20. I don't know. Sometimes it's $20. Sometimes it ranges up to like $30. I remember when it used to be $30, and Little Big Planet 2 used to be $10. I mean, I don't understand why it was so expensive. But that's probably one of the reasons why, because it's really good. It's a really good game. It's the best out of all, you know. Let me know your opinions on what you think. Should you actually buy it? Should you not? Is it worth getting? Like I said, in my opinion, it's worth getting. Just spend a couple of dollars, you know, here and there. Do whatever you can just to get the game. If you already have it, then cool. You know what I'm talking about. I mean, honestly, this game was life. But thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Should You Buy It?